please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
Rajat, what about you? Is the bottom far? I mean, Ashwini says just go on doing ETFs and at some point you will hit bottom. Does it look like the bottom is what, 10,750? That's what some technical guys say. Or are you already buying?
Hi, Lata. Well, I think I am no expert to predict a bottom for this market. But I also think that the segments that have fallen in this market meaningfully are trading at an index level much below than what the index is today reflecting. So this market at every phase keeps surprising us on how polarized it keeps on getting. So you have technology which has hit a new high today, and you have financials which have hit a new low today. I think we, as you rightly coined the show, the fear factor is what is more important today, which is what has led to such a big fall in many of the financials. So the more important question today is that what is driving these stocks down and what do we do with them, because any correction in the market is essentially led by these names right now, is what we have seen over the last few days.
Okay. You buying anything, Deepa?
Not really at this point of time. I think just conserving our cash, waiting for the market to settle down. And, you know, you want this whole kind of fear to out of the system, at least as far as the NBFC funding is concerned, and some sort of stability in the debt market, so to speak. So till that point, I think just better to wait and watch. We have seen such corrections, such brutal corrections in the past, and they tend to pass over in a few weeks or so.
Before we just move on, Rajat, to that point about fear, what will stem this fear, according to you? Will it just run its own course, or it needs an intervention?
So, Prashant, I just wanted to brief on two points. Mm-hmm. If you look at the real rate of interest today, and just for simplicity, I'm guessing that we are not changing any of the metrics here. Mm-hmm. The current inflation and the 10-year G-Sec, we have a positive real interest rate of almost close to 4% right mm-hmm. now. Mm-hmm. This is as high as we have seen for a very, very long time now, mm-hmm. right? This kind of a real interest rate does not warrant any further increase in interest rates. I think the problem has been more on the liquidity front right now. And this has been a classic phase over the last few days where your September phenomena of advanced tax collections, your dollar, your rupee support, and plus some rollovers that may have been happening in the debt market all just coincided together. Mm. I think it's just a matter of time that some of these things will just settle on their own, because we are not fearful of rates shooting up. We are only seeing a liquidity environment being tight, which has created some kind of a panic in the last few days into the market. And we think that normally these things don't last long. They and the government, along with the regulatory agencies, have indicated a very, very strong indication that they are going to step in, and I think you will see them taking steps very soon. So mm-hmm. things will fall back on their own, mm. right? And then probably, you know, going forward, we'll realize that some of these stocks probably traded too cheap for us to buy them.
Okay. Well, actually, that is our second headline, Rajat, to stay on. The second headline is exactly that. The Reserve Bank of India and the SEBI's efforts to talk up the markets went in vain. The NBFCs continue to fall as the stocks saw severe selling pressure, fears of higher cost of funds continue to grip the sector. Well, like I said before, there were no trades in the debt market. But usually CPs are not traded a great deal. CPs are traded somewhat. Corporate bonds are hardly ever traded. They are bought and held to maturity. There are few and far between trades. But now there is a fear of buying. And that is what is pushing yields higher. At what particular yield people will be prepared to buy, we don't know. But if that is known, then perhaps the markets will fall further, fearing that if NBFCs, you know, have to pay such a high, you know, double digits for the cost of money, then they will not grow at the 30-40% that they are showing. And therefore, giving them a price to book of 3, 4 and 5 is uncalled for. So it is this fear that is continuing to bedevil the NBFC stocks. The fact that they were priced for a 30% growth and they were priced for 3, 4, and 5 times book, and therefore they have to come down. And mind you, I mean, Bajaj Auto, Bajaj Finance has fallen how much? It's trading at 52-week lows, is it?
The high was 2,900. It's at about, what, 22 something, right? 2,260 or so.
Okay, so something like a 20% fall. And it is still trading at 7 times book. So, you know, things are expensive. The point is, until now, one thought they will deliver growth. And now you're wondering whether they will. So, Rajat, on that issue to you, before we let you go, will you start buying NBFCs now? Any NBFCs?
So, Lata, I just wanted to brief 2 points on this. First, most of these NBFCs benefited when they migrated to borrow money from the CP or the NCD market as interest rates started falling down and banks were not lowering the rate in that same magnitude. So, for NBFCs, the arbitrage to borrow money directly from the market was far cheaper. Before that, they used to borrow money from the banks for lending to their segments. I think we will see that process now returning back slowly, but this transition will take some time. And the second more important point is, do we have underlying demand for the products that these NBFCs have been funding for, whether be it a Maruti car, whether be it a real estate house, or whether be it a white capital goods or other segments that Bajaj Finance, you know, like of companies are funding. If there is a demand for those products and the funding comes back instead of market through banks, right, I think we will have to moderate the growth rate. But I agree to the core point of yours that the valuation re-rating that we saw in the NBFCs was a function of easy liquidity. That may not be the scenario. So the markets, in their own wisdom, is readjusting the multiples for these stocks.
Fair enough. Rajat, we'll leave it there. Get well soon. Appreciate you joining in. And thanks very much indeed for joining us today on this show.